Greetings, everyone. This is Alt Lexington on the 10th of February 2020, and I'm about to play the new Task Force operation called To Hell with Honor. It's a new task force that comes with the 10th anniversary of Star Trek Online. And currently it's only available in normal difficulty. There is no advanced or elite difficulty. So this ship is completely overpowered for it. But it is a single target build ship with beam overload and high yield torpedo. So it might not bring down enemies as multiple enemies as fast. However, the queue has just popped, so I should be warping into it anytime soon, and here we go. To hell with honor. The USS Lexington is ready to attack. So we're fighting on a moon, with which is one of the Klingons' biggest shipyards, and Ja'ula from the Discovery series is updating her ships here with all these dishonorable Klingons that are helping her. Not to be mistaken with the regular Klingons. So we first destroy all the ships in this port. While avoiding the cannons and move on to the next indicated port. Although you can attack Ja'ula's ship itself. To try and make it run away. Why is my anti-time not working today? Oh, I remember why. I took it off the build. Because I've got my active traits set for ground. Okay, there's another shipyard over there. Looks like the players have taken care of some of the others. You've got to be careful in this. Getting shot by these turrets will kill your full impulse. And you might not make it to the shipyards in time to do any destruction. That's where cloaking your ship comes in handy, so probably best to use a ship with a built-in cloaking device, plus add on a console cloaking device and quantum singularity trait for cloak and subspace field modulator for cloak. See, my full impulse is completely gone and I won't be able to get there in time to... But then the other players are probably suffering the same problem. He's not. He went up high enough. You can try to go up high and avoid some of the cannons, some of the turrets. I forgot to change my active traits back to space traits, but it doesn't matter, it's only normal difficulty. Right, is there another shipyard I'm missing? I think we've got them all. So now we attack the fleet of launched ships, including Ja'ula's, what is it, Lascara? And I overshot it there. Hit her with a quantum phase beam. Somebody else's anti-time is working, that's good. That was my own fault, anti-time is not working. It's because I removed the trait. Now, where next? Now it's time to destroy these reactors near the shipyards so they explode and take out all these Alachi. I'm getting a little bit of lag, but nothing too serious. It's probably from me spacebar spamming too much. And that blast is... When the reactor blows up, it puts out a kind of nuclear blast that spreads out for 5 kilometers, and you don't want to get caught in that if you've not got much survivability. Trying to go up high above the turrets so that full impulse will work. I tend to be able to survive the nuclear blast because I'm overpowered shipper for normal. But you might want to think about hitting evasive maneuvers when that blast happens, if you don't think you could survive it. Some of my characters can't. Target the reactor again, that's the most important thing, and I've lost my full impulse, I must have got shot at or something. No, I was on evasive maneuvers, that's... and it ran out. Sometimes you can lose target lock on the reactor. Yep, the Klingon shipyard is trying to defend itself by opening up mycelial rifts and allowing Alachi through, insane Alachi, to defend. I just usually target the reactors and circle them so they're close to death, and then I start my escape from the blast. This last rift won't close when you blow the reactor though, because the Alachi have gotten wise to your plan to blow reactors to close their rifts. And they bring in their dreadnought once they figure out what you're trying to do. Hit it with a quantum phase beam. Put on some shielding. Bring out my Delta recruits. Should go down pretty easily and pretty quickly. Collect all the loot you can because it's free for all. Now the big Alachi ship is gone, so it's just mopping up now. And done!
quite simple.
I mean, this map, it's a good premise, a good idea, but I don't see myself playing it too often. Because I like to be able to keep up with the team, and since these turret things kill my full impulse, I can't keep up, especially as an engineer in a slow cruisers, my slower cruisers and things. And they still fight you even after the match has ended. Which means you can't hang around and take some beautiful screenshots very easily. But you might be able to farm some loot from them, I don't know about that, I'll have to check that out. But there you go, that's the new map for the 10th anniversary, To Hell With Honor. Only available on normal difficulty at the moment. But it's a beautiful map, and the good thing is you can't crash into the ground. You bounce off of it, I believe. Let's try that now. Suicide! Oh yeah, that's what you do. You don't die from the ground impacts. Not that you'd ever hit the ground on this map, you rarely do. Because you're so busy trying to fly above the turrets to avoid losing your full impulse, because full impulse deactivates when in combat. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this quick little play. There's really not much else to say about it, except when you first come in, you target whichever shipyard needs targeting while avoiding the turrets. Blow up all the ships. Maybe attack the Luscara if you see it. Once the shipyards are destroyed, rifts will start opening around these reactors, and you blow the reactors up to create a kind of nuke that destroys the Alachi rifts. And they get wise to you on the last rift and bring down a dreadnought. Quite easy, really. Simple. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this quick little review. Bye.